What is going on, everybody? This is Jay from Maji and Jay. Today we're going to be getting the unboxing and also the hands-on on this very cool Bluetooth speaker that I purchased from my local retail store, which was Best Buy. Now, I did a lot of research before buying this Bluetooth speaker because I'd never seen it before. So when I searched it on Amazon.com, in which usually they have a little better price, I didn't even see it there. So this thing is absolutely brand new to the market. It's been out for at least 2 months and I have barely seen any videos here on YouTube. So I thought that you guys might be interested because of all the great specifications that it comes with, and I think it stands out from the competition quite well. So as we can tell already, it is made by the company Altec Lansing, and this one is waterproof. It has the certification IP67. So yes, it is waterproof, dustproof, snowproof, pretty much anything proof. As a matter of fact, this thing can even float in the water. Now, not only can it float in the water and that it has the IP67 certification, but this one also has a tremendous battery that will last you about 40 hours with straight usage. Now, the cool part about having such a big battery is that you can also use it as a power bank. So let's say you guys are using this at the park, at the beach, or whatever the case may be, and your smartphone is running out of power, you can actually hook up the USB cable on the backside of the speaker, then connect it to your smartphone, and it will be charging in no time. So if that's not cool, please let me know what it is, guys, because I think this Bluetooth speaker, again, it stands out from the competition quite well according to the price that it has. It is $149 with taxes. It came out to be $158.99. And they had a demo unit at the store. I did play it a little bit, and this one has great bass. I would say better than the new Beats Pill Plus that I tested it, and also has great sound quality. So here, without further ado, let me go ahead and pop this open so that we can look what's inside. So now, getting this thing out of the box, the first thing we're going to see here is a dual 2-inch drivers, and then on the back side we're going to have one passive bass radiator, which is really nice and is very similar to Bose products and also some of the Beats products as well. On the upper side of this speaker we find the power key. We also have the volume rockers up and down, something very simplistic in my opinion. And then also getting a look here around the speaker, we can see that this thing is actually quite rugged. It comes with this casing. It's made of rubber. This is for the impact proof capabilities. And then here we're going to find some of the connectors. We have the charging port. We also find the auxiliary 3.5 millimeters in. We have the USB port for charging purposes. This is where you guys will connect your smartphone or whatever device you're using. Keep in mind that it is only a 5-volt one. So it is intended mostly for smartphones. On the bottom side, we have the female tripod connector. That's because you can hook it up to a tripod or whatever accessories you guys want to hook up to it. And I believe that inside of the box, we are also going to find a mount. So setting this aside, let's go ahead and check all the accessories that this thing came with. And one of them is the mount that I was just talking about right now. And let me go ahead and take a look at it because it looks quite interesting to me. This is the mount that I'm talking about, and it comes with this little hook. I'm really not sure where you can use this, maybe for a bicycle or something of that nature, so you guys can see here. So that's very nice. The next thing we got here is a piece of that mount that I just showed you, and then finally we have the Allen driver. Okay, and that's pretty much it what we have for the accessories. Next we got the manuals, and they don't seem to be very professional. It's just one piece of paper, and when we open it, you're going to see here some of the details on how to connect it, how to install the mount, how to plug it in, and pretty much how to use it. Now, something that I need to get educated on is on the voice commands, and it is also compatible with Android and iOS, which is really, really cool. You can use it with Siri. And then it also comes with NFC capabilities, as you guys can tell from this manual. So that's very cool. We're going to be testing it in just a moment. Next, you have a little white box. Maybe in here, you're going to find the power adapter. I'm not sure. Let me go ahead and take a look here with you guys. And inside, yes, we do have the power adapter. This is for charging purposes. So it seems very simplistic all the way around. As a matter of fact, there we have the branding. And it looks actually quite generic. Let me see. Here we have the specifications. It is a 5-volt, 1-amp charger. So it is very similar to the ones that we see on smartphones. Then we got here the USB cable. I'm assuming that this is only for charging purposes. And it is the micro kind as well. And then finally, we had the auxiliary 3.5 millimeter cable. So this is in case you guys don't want to use the Bluetooth capabilities, then you can use this auxiliary cable. Now the awesome part about the Bluetooth on this speaker is that they are claiming that it goes up to 50 feet of range. So yes, we know already that it comes with NFC and such. So now let me go ahead and clean the table so that we can test this baby out. So now that we got everything ready with this Altec Lansing Boomjacket Bluetooth speaker, I am ready to give you the hands-on. And yes, I already charged it and everything is set to go. So something that I want to mention that is quite annoying on this Bluetooth speaker is that every time you press the power key, it's going to give you this welcome message that at first I thought it was just the initiation of the speaker or whatever. But now it's going to be every single time that you power it off and then power it back on, it's going to give you the exact same message over and over. So let me give you here the quick demonstration.
Powering on. Welcome to Altec Lansing.
There it is. With this being said, to get this thing paired to your device, you have two different options, and one of them is NFC and the other one is just the standard Bluetooth pairing. Now NFC is actually quite convenient because all you need to do is enable it on your device. You touch the upper side of the speaker and that's about it. Now if you don't have NFC capabilities on your device, all you have to do is just hold and press the power key for about 3 seconds and it'll go into Bluetooth pairing mode, which is what we have here right now. So in this case, I'm just going to do the demo with the NFC capability so that way you guys can see how well it is working. And again, all you have to do is just tap it on the upper side of the speaker and there we have the message. So I'm going to select yes, so that way we are paired and there we saw the little Boomjacket message. So it should be paired in no time. As we can tell, my Bluetooth is currently turned on and I got another message.
Enjoy.
And there we have the message that we have been paired, and after you do so, this blue light will remain solid. That means that you have a successful connection. Now, in case you guys are curious, I do have here my USB cable for my Samsung Galaxy S7, and we're going to go ahead and connect it on the back side just to test it out and see if this thing is truly going to charge the smartphone or not. Now, in this video, I am testing it with you guys. Believe it or not, I haven't tested this feature as of right now, so let me go ahead and see if it's not going to fail. It is a 5-volt output, so it should be just fine. And right now, we are charging. Wow, this is absolutely phenomenal, guys. We can see right there that I am connected. And let me show you here that I am not cheating, because I know a lot of you guys have a lot of doubts whether or not my videos are legit, and I do understand that that's because I do a lot of replica videos and such, but here it is. We do have the USB cable connected to the smartphone, and once again, it is charging just like a charm, which is really, really neat. So now that we tested the charging capabilities on this Bluetooth speaker, the next test would be the most important one, which is the sound test, and for that, I will be using some non-copyrighted songs. I do apologize if you guys don't like them, but yes, let's go ahead and get started.
Consumes you, if it takes root inside you, if it makes you dream, then let it. You've made something beautiful. Now make a website.
So there we have it for the sound test on this little Boomjacket speaker, and let me tell you guys that the sound quality is absolutely phenomenal. I'm not sure how my microphone captured it because I don't have the most sophisticated mic out there. As a matter of fact, I am planning to change it very soon. But based on what I heard, the sound clarity, the bass, everything on this speaker is absolutely outstanding. As a matter of fact, I tested it at my local Best Buy store like I mentioned before. and I compared it with other brands such as Beats. I used the Mega Boom, the Boom 2. Now the Mega Boom was absolutely great. It was much better than this speaker. But now when I compared it to the Beats Pill, the new one that came out, which is the Plus model, I believe it's called, this one was a lot better in sound clarity and also bass. So yes, I think I did a great purchase. Again, guys, this is waterproof, shockproof, pretty much anything proof out there. And the next testing we're going to do here is the voice commands. Now this is a feature that not every Bluetooth speaker carries out there. So to do so, it's actually quite simple. First of all, you guys must do the initial setup where your device is going to ask you the permissions that you allow this device to access the voice control on your smartphone. After that's completed, then all you have to do is just double press on the power key quickly and it'll take you to the voice commands on your smartphone. So let me give you the demonstration. Call Mylan.
Calling Mylan, mobile.
Hey baby, what's up?
Hi Jay, how are you?
I'm testing my new little sucker here.
Great.
How can you hear me?
I hear you very well.
Oh wow, that sounds great. Well, thank you so much. Bye bye now.
You're welcome. Bye.
Bye. Well guys, there we saw the little demo. I called my wife and she said that everything was great with the quality on the mic. Remember that you're using the mic built in on the actual speaker. So that was quite great. And also you can use it for other commands such as if you want to know where you are, if you want to know where your nearest store is or whatever the case may be, you can use it with this Bluetooth speaker, which is absolutely great. So with this being said, we are all set to move to the next step, and that's going to be the waterproof testing on this little Bluetooth speaker. I really want to know if it's IP67 certified or not. So let me go ahead and grab my big bucket of water. Here we go. Alrighty guys, so here we have the water ready, and yes, this is water. I don't want anybody to have any doubts whether or not I am honest here. So yes, the water is all set. Now before you get this in contact with water, make sure that everything is sealed on the back side. You don't want any water getting in there. And here we go guys. 1, 2, and 3. So right now it's trying to float as they advertise this product to be a floating speaker. And so far we can see that it's fully covered in water. I do see some bubbles already, so I'm not sure if water is getting inside of the device. So now that it is in water, let me go ahead and dry my hands here briefly, because my Samsung Galaxy S7 is also waterproof. So I'm going to do something that I think is going to be a little bit funny. I'm going to put the Samsung Galaxy S7 also into water. I'm going to leave it like this so that way you can hear the sound. Both of them in water. Look at that. There we go. I think I'm all set for the summertime, guys. What do you think? I can feel the air coming out of the speakers. Look at this flashing. That's fun. Okay. Everything's working well. My Samsung is also working nicely. Well, there we have it for the water test on this IP67 certified device. And yes guys, it did hold it very well. I mean, I left it in there for about a minute or so and everything's still working perfectly well. Now I'm not sure exactly for how long you can leave this in water. I think it's going to be maybe for 30 minutes or so before you can cause any damage to the actual speaker. But yes, I'm truly impressed with the quality. I like the sound quality. I like the bass. I like everything about it. I like the feature of having voice commands on the speaker. That's definitely a plus for it. And I also like the range. If I forgot to mention, this thing has about 50 feet of range with the Bluetooth connectivity. So everything about the speaker is positive and I do like it, including the battery. I like the option of being able to use it as a power bank. So this is a very complete product in my opinion. But as always, if you guys do have any questions or comments to say, leave them below. Don't forget to like this video, subscribe for more. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you on my next one.